All right. You ready to go down the road?
Yeah.
First time that we've been in the van. Let's see if you can get your head straight. There you go. That looks a lot better. Yeah. Does that feel better for your neck?
Yeah.
All right. Getting ready to pull out of the driveway. And first time we've been out in quite a few weeks. I had to charge the battery. Yep. It's nice to get out. Well, it's been so cold, right?
Yeah, it's been cold. Please don't jerk my neck like that, though.
I'm trying to go as smooth as I can. If you could straighten your head up a little bit more to the right, it would. Let me see if I can just kind of hold you a little bit. There you go. Smile, you're on candid camera. I saw that smile. Frankie's been in a lot of pain. It's been hard to get her out of bed, and it was hard today, but it just felt like we had to get out some. She's not seen sunshine in weeks. But her paralyzed limbs, her left arm and left leg, are very painful for her. And just any kind of movement at all hurts them. Even when I raise and lower the back of the bed, the hospital bed, it kind of stretches her one way or the other, and it causes those limbs to hurt. So you're going down Williamsburg Road. Oops, you okay?
Yeah.
I know it hurts, every little bump. Let's see. There we are in the town of Sanston.
Whoopee.
Airplane just flew right overhead in front of us. So just give you some more updates on Frankie. We've noticed a lot of good, positive improvement, much more so in the last couple of weeks, 2 to 3 weeks. And possibly that's why the limbs are starting to hurt more. I've seen movement in the leg especially. I've seen some in the arm, but the leg has just been bending at the knee, which it never did before. Don't know if it's not a reflex, what's the word I'm looking for? Contraction or not, contracture. It could be that it's not really the brain communicating with the limb, but it sure seems like it to me, and sometimes it gets very light as opposed to, well, most of the time it's so heavy. It feels like a sack of concrete when I go to lift it up to put her slacks on her or something like that. So I'm looking at it all as positive, and I still believe the Lord is at work, and he's bringing healing on her body and healing to our souls, and giving us more insight to his character and how much he loves us and how he allows situations like this to happen to build us up. Paul said in the New Testament that we're being conformed to be more like Christ. From the time we're born again until the time we leave the earth, we never get to perfection. And I can tell you for sure that I'm not anywhere near perfection. But the longer we walk with him and the more in step with him we stay, then the more growing we'll do and the more maturing we'll become, and we'll be conformed to be more like Christ as time goes on. So I know that what's been happening is good for us spiritually, and it certainly has been for me. It's caused me to have even a deeper love and appreciation towards the Lord for what he's doing in us and what he's done through us. And also believe that the devil might be at work too. And maybe you're wondering, how can the devil be at work at the same time God is? It just reminds me of Job, when the devil went before the Lord and he accused Job. And the Lord told, was so proud of Job, what a good man he was. And the devil said, yes, but he's so blessed, if you take away some of the things that he's blessed with, he'll turn on you. And the Lord said, you can do to Job what you want, but you can't take his life. And the devil caused a lot of pain and affliction and agony and loss to come upon Job. He lost his family. They died. Some of them died. And he lost his wealth and riches and everything. But at the end, the Lord restored Job to a better place than he had been before. So that's the way I believe God works, and sometimes the devil has his way with us just because God's using it to hone us and to sharpen us and to make us more usable by him. All good things work towards those who love the Lord and who are the called according to his purpose, the Bible says. Even in the midst of any valley we've ever been through, I can look back and see where God has caused more good than bad. So we're just trusting him. Frankie is having a very, very hard time these days. She's in a lot of pain, and she gets discouraged. But she still knows that God is in control, and that everything is going to be okay in the end, because he promised us that. And God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Hath he said, shall he not do it? Hath he spoken, and shall he not make it good? And you think about that. God is not a liar, and promises that he's given us in his word are true, and we can depend on them and rely on them. So I'm determined that whatever happens, I'm not going to give up on God, and I'm going to stay the course, like Paul said. I'm going to keep fighting the fight, and then there'll be that day that Paul spoke of. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And Paul also said that, make sure I can turn here. Let's see, where was I?
Paul said to be absent.
Yeah, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And he also said that to live is Christ and to die is gain. And he lived his life like that. He praised the Lord when he was in prison, when he was whipped, when he was beat, when he was shipwrecked, and all the valleys that Paul went through. He was singing praises all along the way and giving the glory to God, because he knew that to live is Christ, to die is gain. And that's the way it is for me. As long as I'm alive, I'm going to live for Christ. And then when I'm gone, I'll be with Christ and with my Savior. So I just want to let you guys know that we're still here. I don't do a lot of updates. It's not a whole lot of different things to share with you, but I just felt like on this second day of the new year that it would be good to just affirm to our friends and our family that we're still here, we still need your prayers, and we still struggle with the flesh. I get discouraged myself. Frankie gets discouraged. Sometimes I get down and depressed, to be honest with you. But when that happens, I've got the scripture that I can rely on and pull up. So glad that I went through a discipleship program or two when I was going through my walk, especially the early days at Grove Avenue Baptist. Went through a very good discipleship course, and it really put a lot of emphasis on scripture memory. And I would like to encourage any of you to delve into the scripture and memorize some verses, because when you do get in trouble or go through trouble, there's nothing more comforting than to be able to think of a scripture, and the Holy Spirit always brings them up. And it's amazing how powerful the Word of God is when you commit it to memory. It's not it's the living Word, and you have a spirit within you if you're born again, the Holy Spirit. And that spirit coordinates with your your mind to bring up those promises and all that you can rely on and hold on to. So if you haven't done any scripture memory, and I'm guilty of not doing a whole lot lately, I need to brush up on my verses and learn some new ones. So I'm preaching to myself too, but in this day and time, scripture memory is a very important part of growing in the Lord and becoming to be more like Christ. So that's our update for today. Frankie, I'm sorry I talked your ears off. Are you okay, or are your ears hurting?
I'm asking you to slow down a little.
You're asking me to slow down. Okay. Let's give them the bird's eye view. There we go.
It's hurting my head.
We're on Laburnum Avenue coming up to the 64 interchange.
And it's awfully bumpy.
Frankie feels every bump in the road. So it's not very comfortable for her. We're probably going to head on home now, because she gets very, very tired very fast. But at least we went through the motion of getting out of the bed and doing the Hoyer and stretching some limbs and joints. There's a nice Harley right beside me. You want to go riding on a Harley, Frankie?
No.
How come?
It's not as good as this.
This is bad, but this isn't that bad, right?
This is good.
All right, I'll try to post this tonight, and you guys can have a video and audio update. And Happy New Year to you. May the Lord bless you in 2023. May the Lord bless America in 2023. We need healing in our land, so keep on praying. And praying for each other, loving each other, and in the Word, going about God's business. And we love you.